Okay, I have cut out a piece of cardboard from just a little box that was sitting under some tea bags in the supermarket, and I'm going to paint it white and then leave it so that I can paint it with different colours afterwards. And I believe it's a fisherman in a tiny boat, because the fisherman is enormous, on the sea. And I'm going to cut a slit here. And I'm going to give him some other arms as well. And then I'll explain what else to do in a wee while. The elements that I've cut out, I've got my main character here. I've got his two arms, or her two arms, I'm not sure which it is yet. I've got a bar that the arms will be attached to. And then I've got the pull thing which will be attached to the middle of that. And I'm going to paint it now. Okay, so hopefully all of the little bits are dry enough to work with now. This is the pull. So the pull has to be slotted in to about there. There's nothing scientific about the measurements. You're gonna work them out roughly as you go. Most things work. So there it is, up the back. And then I've got two slots that you'll see there. And in there I'm gonna pop my arms. So they're going in there like that. Now, when I started this, I think I thought I was going to make a fisherman pulling out fish. But I just decided to keep it even simpler than that, and he's just going to sort of dive in, the poor soul. So, right. Now it gets a little bit trickier as you've got arms going all over the place. Let's check the length of them. Oh, yes, they're fine. Right, we want them going straight though, unfortunately. Can't have them at an angle. Right, so the pull and the arms attached to this. So I think I might put that back a bit further down. There and there. All attached to that. We might have to put some slots to hold this in place, but at the moment that's fine. So, I'm going to double-sided sellotape that all into place. For time, you could use glue if you wanted, because you've got time to wait for it to dry. This is just super quick, as long as you can get the backing tape off it. There we go. So, I'm going to and stick the one that's on the pull at the back of it as well, so it's all held in place. Don't do that with the arms, just with the pull. So that's wrapped around there. And then, so I don't extract my teeth and use my scissors. Okay, there we go. Two bits of sticky tape, double-sided, take the back off, stick it down, or just use a glue stick. Now let's hope this works. So, and then I pull, and I push it back, and I pull, and it's sort of diving in. Now I'm going to try and make some different examples. That's my first one. But it works. I'm going to trim these bits off the edge so you can't see them. I hope you have fun doing that. I'll try and show you some more examples as we go. Take care. Bye. I did a wee last minute adjustment and I added a vegetable net and some fish that I've just made. So when I pull it up, the fish get pulled up too. The only problem then is I've got to pull the net down to get it back, but I prefer it because there's more of a story to it. Okay, take care.